come down from Minden to start telling people more about the Coordination Corps. How has it been going since it started?
Oh, really well. We moved onto the land just before Christmas. The land is 1,000 acres, over 1,000 acres. And the cost was just over 100,000, which we raised by selling shares of $200. We've sold, I think we've got about, sold over 300 shares, and there's about 200 more to be sold. We've taken possession of about two-thirds of the land, and we take over the rest when we pay the rest. I think we've got about 6 months at the most to raise the rest of the money.
And so you're going to be touring the capital cities trying to interest people in buying shares from the commune?
Yeah, both in sort of trying to find more people to join with it, but also just to make contact with people, because like Nimbin isn't necessarily only a place on the map, it's sort of a state of some sort of communication of consciousness. Mm. That
what kind of consciousness?
Well, just sort of there's people who are living their ideals or their dreams and practically sort of bringing about the new age, which is sort of the brotherhood of man under the fatherhood of God.
How is the Nimbin Caravan is what the group...
Yeah, the Nimbin Caravan is...
What are you going to be doing?
It's a group of people from all over the Nimbin district, not just Tundubil, but all over the district, who, well, it's been wet season lately, so there's been lots of time to make a lot of craft and things like that, and a lot of communication. And so getting together all the arts and crafts and music and dance and acrobatics and everything like that. And we're going to be travelling Sydney the first week of March, and we'll be at the village church in Paddington, Oxford Street, and the universities, and then into Adelaide for the Arts Festival, and Melbourne, probably at Montserrat, Canberra, then back up to Nimbin.
A lot of people down here are very cynical about communal living. Do you find that it really works?
I don't think there's any other way. Like, depends what you mean by communal living. Communal as in everybody on top of each other and overcrowding each other can never work, because our conditioning has been sort of one that we need space. Communal living and sharing the necessities of life, such as working together in the garden to produce the food that we need. And without sort of the communal living in this form, where people possibly have their own dwellings, we've got 1,000 acres up there, we can have lots of dwellings and people sort of having their own sort of life, but sharing their needs with their brothers and sisters, then makes life much easier, and it cuts out the whole sort of materialistic sort of over needs, you know.
Yeah.